This is why a man leaves his father and his mother and unites with his wife so that they can become a new family. From the beginning of the creation, God always had a preference of commitment because he was committed to us. And because of that, we should commit to one another. And what better display of that commitment than marriage? In an age where commitment is seen as old-fashioned or weakness or the ways of a patriarchy, the Father sees it as a way we can represent him in the earth.
Love, 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 love. That's all it is, buddy. Love, love, love. Forgive and go forward. Don't look to the right, to the left. In Jesus' name.
Male and female. Full expression of God in you. What stronger expression of that than marriage? Commitment means to be responsible for or to be dedicated to something or someone. But without action, that commitment will go unseen. Love is patient and kind and not envious. It doesn't brag. It's not puffed up. It's not rude. It's not self-serving or easily angered or resentful. It's not glad about injustice, but rejoices in truth and bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. But have we ever wondered why that is? Because we know love is present when we see these attributes in action. Love wasn't meant to remain unseen, and nor was our commitment. There are prerequisites a man must be assured of in his heart prior to engaging in marriage: forsaking all others, providing for and protecting this woman, laying down his life for her. Likewise, there are things a woman must be assured of in her heart: following this man, bearing his children, taking his name, all just to name a few. We do these things so that our commitment can be seen by the other. Take charisma to be your wife. Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only to her through richer, poorer, sickness, health for the rest of your natural life?
I do.
Charisma, do you take Calvary to be your husband, to love and honor and cherish and protect him, forsaking all others, holding only to him through richer, poorer, sickness, and health for the rest of your natural life? I promise I heard that. She said I do. Best man, you have the rings? after me. With this ring, charisma, I pledge.
With this ring, charisma, I pledge.
My unending devotion to you.
My unending devotion to you.
Just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
So will my love for you.
So will my love for you.
Calvary.
Calvary.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge my unending devotion to you.
I pledge my unending devotion to you.
And just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
Nor will my love for you have an end.
Nor will my love for you have an end.
The scriptures talk about how a threefold cord is not easily broken. And so though this man has made a pledge to this woman, and this woman returning has made a pledge to this man, we also know that pledges are being made today also before the Lord himself. And so with that, we're going to do the sand spell. So just as this sand represents Calvary and this charisma, this is the Lord. And they are three distinct colors, but in here become something new. And just as prior to today, you had a Calvary Zender and a Charisma Thompson, they will leave this place as something new. They will leave this place as Calvary and Charisma. Nice. You gotta do it kind of at the same time. I'm trying to skill enough. There we go. There we are. All right, let me try some of the off-white here. It's got to be more God than them. Go ahead, put a little bit more. And so though they came in here separate, they leave as a new color, as a completely new thing. All right, so let me step back forward. Now, what God himself has brought together, let no human try to separate. And so for the first time publicly, I would like to present to you all, Mr. and Mrs. Calvary Zender. You may kiss your bride.
And through that, I saw Calvary grow so much into he became bold. He became someone who is not the man you see today, essentially. He was so different even just a year and a half ago. So different. He's timid. Now he's smiley. He'll talk to anybody. You know, he'll chat your ear off, get him on the right subject. And one day he's like, man, I met this girl on this app. I was like, oh, really? You did? And he's like, yeah, I think I really like her. I was like, oh, all right, man, we'll just take it easy. He didn't listen, but that's okay. We're going to fast forward, and now we're here today celebrating them, and I am so happy for this couple.
These twin sisters that were like best friends. They were like three houses up. I don't know why, Sydney. Oh, you already know the story. I don't know why, but they had walked down behind the houses and they started tearing their castles down. They just started kicking them down. And all in the front with Jared and some other kids, we were playing on some bikes, and all I hear is this scream. Like all the way, from the back of the house, I could hear Charisma screaming for me. And so I just ran. And I didn't even realize I was fighting until I had pushed my best friends down and I was kicking people. I didn't even realize I had gotten into a fight. So then mom came out there and was like, what you fighting for? What are you doing? And I was like, they knocked down Charisma and Rihanna's castles. And she's like, oh, okay, no problem. It's fine. Get back to it.
For you I bleed myself dry. It's true.